Shalom, friends. This is once again your friend and brother, Chidi Osuchukwu, a bond servant of Yehovah. Today, I want to talk to you about calendar and time. Yehovah created the world. We see in Genesis chapter 1, it says, in the beginning, Yehovah created the heavens and the earth. He is the one that created the heavens and the earth. He made it, and then he gave us ability to track along time with him. He lives outside of time. He is timeless, but he allows us to track time with him. I guess it would be very resourceful and exciting for us humans to understand what time it is in heaven. The first clue we see to that is in the creation of the day. He says, morning and evening makes a day. It's important for us to realize that our Father Yehovah is our primary educator. But when we do go to school, Western education, civilization, and society tends to teach us something different. But the first thing we should have learned is to know about our Creator, which we should learn from home. And if you learn that from home, your parents will obviously open the first page of the Bible, Genesis chapter 1, and you will see Yehovah made light. And then he says, evening and morning makes a day. Therefore, a day, according to him, starts in the evening. By the time you get to 6 years old or 3 years old or 4 years old, then you go to school. And by the time you get to the third or fourth grade, they're teaching you time. Then they say to you, a day starts at midnight. Then as you have grown up and listening to this video, you must ask yourself, who shall you believe? The Creator who made the day, who made the heavens and the earth, or your teacher and your educational system that says a day begins at midnight. But the truth is that there is one who created heavens and the earth, and his name is Yehovah, and he's the one that has given us time. In Genesis chapter 1 and verse 14, he made two great lights. He said, the greater light shall rule the day, and the lesser light shall rule the night. And the day is the light part of the 24 hours. The greater light is obviously the sun, and the lesser light is the moon. He didn't stop there. He said, those lights shall be for reckoning of days, reckoning of months, and reckoning of years, as well as his appointed time. So the sun and the moon has four primary functions: to tell us when a day begins, to tell us when a new moon begins, a new month begins, to tell us when a new year begins, and to tell us all the appointments, parties, and festivals of our Creator. Now, like I said, this is supposed to be the first thing you learn from home by your parents before you even go to school. If you learn that at home, and when you do then get to school and somebody teaches you otherwise, then you say, hey, you are talking against the Bible or contrary to the Bible, and therefore you will seek to get clarification. Now, that brings us to the last part of the functions of the two great lights, which is the appointed times of the Creator. In Leviticus chapter 23, Yehovah detailed his appointed time. He started by saying, Aaron and Moses, please, these are my appointed time. You shall proclaim them at their appointed time. Not when you want, but the time that I have given to you. If you do that, then you can track along with me to know what time it is in heaven. And if you know what time it is in heaven, then you are not in darkness. Just like Paul told the Thessalonians in Thessalonians chapter 5, he told them that they are not in darkness. It's important for us to know. Otherwise, your pastor, your theologian, your priest may tell you, I heard a preacher preaching the other day and said the book of Esther, that Haman decided to exterminate the Jews in December. That is not the case. Yes, it was in the 12th month, but that 12th month is as according to the counting of Yehovah in the scriptures and not according to the counting that we have on our calendar. So in the calendar of Yehovah, there is an appointed time that is coming soon. In a couple of days' time, it will be the new moon. And that new moon ushers in a new year. It might sound absurd, but the Creator is the one that created the heavens and the earth. And there is nothing anyone can say about that. So in a 2-3 days time, you look up, you will see a brand new moon telling us that a new year has just begun. It is in this new year that Moses entered into Egypt, performed by the hand of Yehovah through Moses 10 plagues that made Pharaoh to say, take your people and go. It is also in this period that Yeshua, the greatest man that ever walked the earth, was in Jerusalem, as we see in John chapter 12, for the feast of Passover. Of course, on the 14th of the new year, a time like this, which we shall enter in a few days' time, and then 2 weeks later will be the Passover, was the day the greatest sacrifice that repurchased us to God, Yehovah, and gave us hope of salvation, returned the hope of salvation to us, was done. Therefore, I want to encourage you, even amidst the challenges that the world is facing currently with COVID-19, with every pandemic that may come tomorrow, remember that all you need to be is in the will of Yehovah, and to be in His will, you need to know His timing. His timing is that around Tuesday or Wednesday, when as we look up to sky for the new moon, because in Exodus chapter 12, Yehovah called Moses and He said to him, "You guys have been in Egypt for a long time. The Egyptians have taught you how to count their timing, but I want to recalibrate your mind. Look up, Exodus chapter 12 and verse 1, this new moon that you see shall be for you the beginning of years." Therefore, we know that our Father in heaven has a beginning of years, and it's not in January. We are about to enter that new moon. Look around you, you will see spring, everything springing to life, people becoming upbeat, grasses and flowers growing, the sun shining tells you we are in that phase of time when it is a new year. And with that new year comes, on the 14th of that new first month, comes the Feast of Passover and Unleavened Bread. Feast of Passover was in the day that Yeshua was sacrificed, that His blood will repurchase us. Feast of Unleavened Bread demonstrates that once you repent and allows the blood to take care of the death penalty that you should have paid with your own life, you then start to study the word and begin to take out what is leaven, what is sin, what are interpretations. It was Yeshua that explained what leaven is to His disciples. He said leaven can also mean the wrong interpretations of the Pharisees. So some of the interpretations that your religious leaders and priests and pastors and apostles and prophets may have given to the scripture may be wrong. And those are leaven that you need to take out. You are encouraged in the scripture to study for yourself so that you can show yourself approved. The only thing that approves you in heaven is study and acquiring knowledge. Little wonder Yehovah spoke in Hosea chapter 4 verse 6a. He says, "My people perish for lack of knowledge." And B says, "You perish because you rejected knowledge, because you rejected my laws." Many people forget to quote the part B. Knowledge of Yehovah is in His laws. Rejecting His laws leads to perishing. And that's why John chapter 3 verse 16 gives us only two options. "For Yehovah so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish." Lack of knowledge of His laws leads to perishing. And that's why in Exodus chapter 20 and verse 6 to 8, He says, "I will have mercy on thousands that love me by keeping my commandments." You cannot love Yehovah if you don't keep His commandments. And one of His greatest commandments is keep time according to His timepiece. He's given us a timepiece made up of the sun, the moon, and His appointed times. And in a few days' time, like I said earlier, there will be New Year, and in about 17 days' time will be the Passover. It doesn't matter what you have learned in the past. It doesn't matter what tradition or religion that you belong to. If you believe that the God of the Bible is the creator of the heavens and the earth, pick up your Bible, see what He has said we will do there, and do them. Therefore, I encourage you, find a believing assembly. I attend Hebrew Root Assembly, and I want to encourage you to join us as much as you can, even with the whole pandemic. But the most important thing is for you to focus on the commandments of Yehovah. Celebrate Passover, celebrate Feast of Unleavened Bread, and live your life without leaven. It was Paul that spoke in 1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 7. He said, "Let us keep the feast." What feast? Feast of Passover and Unleavened Bread. "Not with the leaven of malice, but with the unleavened bread of righteousness." Therefore, none of the apostles after Yeshua decided to jettison the feast. Reconsider what you have been taught. Reconsider what you have been told. They may be wrong. And if they are wrong, you are primarily responsible. Your pastor, your church, your leaders, your prophets, will not stand with you at the throne of judgment. You alone will stand. And the Father will say, I gave you my word. I spoke to my prophet. They wrote them down. I sent my son. Every feast he was there, from when he was 12 years old, he was at the feast of Passover. After his fasting in the wilderness, he went to the feast of Passover. In John chapter 12, he arrived 6 days earlier at the house of Lazarus, and that was where he was until on the 13th day he went to Jerusalem, and then that was then the day they had the supper, and the next day he was sacrificed as our Passover lamb. Now you understand that Messiah, Yeshua, as written in your Bible, Christ, our Passover lamb, have been sacrificed. Passover is coming. Are you going to keep that memorial? Remember the ultimate sacrifice of the one, the greatest man that walked the earth, the greatest sacrifice that his Father made, and him willingly accepting. Are you willing to make that sacrifice? To reconsider and challenge the things you have been taught in the past and turn towards Yehovah and become righteous in his sight by obeying his laws, so that you can then inherit eternal life. Join us in Hebrew Assembly, 5152 Ogba Ejaye Road, to celebrate the upcoming New Year and the Feast of Passover around the 8th and the 9th of April, all the way for 7 days, all the way to the 16th of April, as we obey Yehovah and honor him. Shalom, and Yehovah bless you.